Today we're talking about working with arrays in Perl, ordered collections of scalar values. To create an array in Perl, we must assign a variable with the at sigil from a list of values. In Perl, a list is a parenthesized, comma-separated collection of values. To set or retrieve one of those values, I use square brackets to index or subscript that array. In Perl, arrays are zero indexed. If I'm requesting one variable, I use the dollar sigil. And I can assign it new values. There are other ways to produce a list of values other than just specifying them literally. One is the quote word operator, which takes a delimited list of values and splits them by white space. Another way to produce a list of values is to use the range operator, two dots, to produce a sequential range of values. Integers are common, but strings work here too. Now, if I want to retrieve or modify multiple values in the array, I can index with a range of values, and I use the at sigil in an operation known as slicing. If I assign values from a shorter list here, empty values are filled with undef. If I assign values from a longer list, that list is truncated. Unlike C, arrays in Perl have a known length and can vary in size as our program runs. To find the current size of an array, we cast it into the scalar context with the scalar keyword. We can also use $#A to find the greatest existing index. I can grow and shrink an array in many ways. One common way is to treat it as a stack or a queue. Perl defines push and pop on arrays. Push lets us easily append one or more values, returning the new number of values in the array. Pop consumes the last value in the array. Similarly, I can prepend one or more values to the array using unshift. And I can remove the first value with shift. These are useful for dealing with, for example, command line arguments or subroutine parameters, which in Perl are both provided as arrays. Let's say I have some data. I've written a subroutine show A which shows me that list of values a little bit more compactly, so here's that data again. Now let's say I want to reverse this. I could faff around with a loop, or I could just use reverse. What if I wanted to sort my data? Sure, again, I could implement my own sort, but I really want to just get things done, so I just use sort. Surprise! Sort produces a naturally sorted list of values. It uses lexicographic comparison, so it only works sensibly on strings, not on numbers. So what if we want a numeric sort, or some other particular order? Well, we can provide our own comparison block, which defines an expression that's evaluated for pairs of values, $A and $B, to determine the order they should be in. It can be arbitrarily complex too. What if I wanted to find a value? Well, I can use grep, which takes a block defining a filter and a list of values, and it returns only those values where that filter evaluated to true. What if I wanted to transform all the values? Well, I can use map, which again takes a block defining a transformation and a list of values, and it returns the list of values with the transform applied to each. Chaining sort, grep and map together can yield powerful pipelines of value filtering and transformation. We've only just scratched the surface of what we can do with arrays in Perl. For a longer list of array techniques, check out the Perl documentation collection.